Good day. If you were asked to give the prime factors or to write a number as the product of prime factors, what will you do? So today we are looking at the product of prime factors. First thing, what does product mean? Times. So I want you to write a number in terms of other numbers, and that other numbers will be prime factors. And we have discussed that in another video. So, but these prime factors need to be multiplied by one another to get to the answer. Let's do an example. I want the product for you to write 12 as the product of prime factors. And there's actually more than one method, but I am going to show you two methods. One method you might have done in primary school already in grade 7. The other method is more common in high school grade 8 and 9. So, for the first method, we call it the tree diagram. I have 12. So I want you now to divide that into factor pairs, or to tell me what factor pair will actually be able to go into 12. Let's say 3 times 4. So I say 3 times 4. But we said it needs to be prime numbers. So is 3 a prime number? Yes. So you can stop there, which means that 3 is also a prime factor of 12. It's a factor of 12, and it's also a prime number. Is 4 a prime number? No. Which means that you can actually multiply two numbers to get 4. And those two numbers might be prime numbers. Let's have a look. What should I multiply to get 4? I can multiply 2 times 2 to get a 4. Is 2 a prime number? Yes. 2? Yes. Now, all of these are now prime numbers. But because they are factors of 12, all of these are prime factors. Now, if I'm asking you to write it as a product of prime factors, you need to tell me that 2 times 2, I prefer that we start with the smallest numbers, 2 times 2 times 3, the same as 12. Let's check. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 3 is 12. You can also write the 2 times 2 as 2 squared times 3, and that is 12. Okay. The second method that I'm going to show you, we call the ladder method. So we can draw a little line, and on the right-hand side, we will write the 12. Now you start off with using your smallest prime number. Smallest prime number is 2. Can 2 go into 12? Can you see that we are now already busy with rules of divisibility? And that we need to be able to know whether it's divisible by 2 or not? Yes, 2 can go into 12 because 12 is an even number. 2 can go into 12 6 times. Or you can think about it in terms of what is half of 12. Can I get the half of 6? Or can 6 be divided by a 2? Yes, 2 can go into 6 3 times. Can 2 go into 3? No. Now go on to your next prime number. That's a 3. Can 3 go into 3? Yes, of course. 3 can go into 3 once. And once you have a 1 there, you can stop. So I would like now to write this in terms of a product of prime factors. So I'm going to say 2 times 2 times 3 is 12. Again, you can say that 2 times 2 becomes 2 squared times 3, and that is 12. Let's do another example. 420. Again, we are going to do it using both methods. First thing, the tree diagram. Okay, it might be easier to start off by the 2. See whether 2 can go into 420. So you can also ask, what's half of 420? 210. So 2 times 210 will give me 420. Is 2 a prime number? Yes. Is 10 a prime number? 210 a prime number? No. What should I multiply with one another to get 210? How about 30 times 7? You could have used other numbers here now. You'll see it end up with the same answer. Is 30 a prime number? No. Is 7 a prime number? Yes. Okay, so 7 is therefore a prime factor of 420. 30. Give me a factor pair of 30. 5 times 6. 5 a prime number? Yes. 6 a prime number? No. But how about 2 times 3? The 2 is a prime number as well as the 3. Now, to write 420 in terms of a product of prime factors, I can say 2 times 2. I like for it to be from small to big. Times 3 times 5 times 7 will give me an answer of 420. Let's do this on the ladder method as well. Start off by using your smallest prime number, 2. Can 2 go into 420? Yes. What's half of 420? 210. Keep on using the 2 until it cannot go into that anymore. Can I get half of 210? Yes, 105. So 2 can go into 210 105 times. Can I get half of 105? Or is 105 an even number? No, because the last digit is not an even number. Okay, so go on to your next prime number, 3. Can 3 go into 105? If you are not sure, use your rules of divisibility. What was the rule for the 3? Add the digits. 1 plus 5 is 6. Can 3 go into 6? Yes. And then 3 will be able to go into 105. And it will go into that 35 times. Carry on with the 3. Can 3 go into 35? 3 plus 5 is 8. No, it can't. Next prime number, 5. What's the rule of divisibility for a 5? Last digits should be a 5. So yes, 5 will be able to go into 35. 5 can go into 35 7 times. And 7 can go into himself once. And now we got actually the prime factors according to our ladder method. So we need to write it now as a product of prime factors. So thus, 2 times 2 times 3 times 5 times 7 equals 420. Boys and girls, I hope that you understand this and that you enjoy this as much as I do. Until next time, goodbye.